Hey guys, Dev with Crime Hive, and I've got breaking news on this story that I've been following with Peter Manfredonia. Many reports have told us that he has been captured in Hagerstown, Maryland, where he was last spotted. And we're going to talk about my perspective leading up to that last bit of information. I've got other videos on this case. If you guys want to be caught up with that, just subscribe to my channel, Crime Hive. And we're going to get into this here. So again, he was just captured. He was not injured. No one was injured. And it seems like it was a peaceful ending to this otherwise tragic case. So we're going to talk about a couple things here. Now, where we left off in the last video, we know that he may have gotten into an Uber towards Maryland. Okay, so that was a possibility. And it turns out that ended up being the case. So one thing I wanted to talk about is, he was on the loose for about 6 days, and and I thought this would end much faster than it did, but it made me realize a couple things. And one being, a lot of people are wearing masks out there, and with these masks, because of the virus, it really doesn't help law enforcement in recognizing someone or other people who could potentially recognize Peter Manfredonia. Now, I found some other articles, and it's really interesting because what these studies have shown, and I'm looking at this little article over here, and basically it's talking about how it's affecting criminal behavior. People are feeling more bold, and they feel like they can get away with more because they're hiding their face. And so we're seeing a lot of criminal activity now. We're seeing criminals put masks on, not necessarily just to be safe and to protect others, but because they can now potentially get away with some of these crimes. We're seeing a lot of robberies. We're seeing a lot of thefts. If you look right here in some of these videos here, people just coming in with their medical masks, and it's just if there's just case after case after case with this. So really interesting, and it made me realize that that's probably part of the reason it was so difficult to find him, to find Peter, even though there was so many states involved, FBI, U.S. Marshals, and so forth. So anyway, just wanted to mention that. I thought that was an interesting fact that these studies have found. These people feel empowered to do things they normally wouldn't do when they're in public. Same thing, kind of like with road rage, for example. People feel safe in their vehicle. They're willing to do a little bit more than they normally would if they were face to face with somebody, and to tend to be more aggressive and very, in a rage, essentially. That's what they call road rage. So anyway, going back to the case here, one of the interesting things we knew was that he possibly got into an Uber. And I just wanted to look more into this because I was wondering, is there really a real-time aspect to this where law enforcement can find out exactly what's going on if he were to use an Uber? And from what I've found from the guidelines here is Uber does have some really neat things in place, and especially if there's an emergency. So law enforcement, if they need to, they can actually request an emergency assistance, and this will instead of getting a signed off order from a judge or getting subpoenas that can take time for that information to develop, they can use this emergency disclosure request essentially to Uber, and then it allows them to get information 24/7 from Uber as information continues to evolve. So for example, if law enforcement is looking for someone, they need to be able to provide unique identifiers associated with that Uber account. So they need to be able to provide an email address, a phone number, a license plate. And then that information gets sent to Uber, and then they have to, look into their data, and then they got to disclose it back to law enforcement. So there is somewhat of a time delay, a time gap, which is why, I think Peter was able to. I don't know if he was using his phone or a different account or what, but he could put in his information. And by the time law enforcement knows about it, he's already at his location. The good news is they were still able to get this information very quickly and still find out where Peter was throughout this investigation. So I knew they were closing in on him, and it was just a matter of time. Again, 23 years old, not a whole lot of experience in life, very smart, very intelligent, had a real potential future. It's just really tragic that it ended in death and so many other crimes associated. So Wanted to know your guys' thoughts on this with Uber. Very interesting there. And I feel like this case could help with the advancement of technology combined with law enforcement and multi-agencies. You know, it can be real difficult when there's multiple agencies and jurisdictions involved. That information is very difficult to really get that information and be able to go off of it. It can be scattered, and again, it can just be a little confusing. So, really interesting here. The other thing I wanted to point out that was interesting was we learned about the vehicle, the 2012 Hyundai Santa Fe. Police believe that Peter did in fact steal this vehicle. I'm curious to know how or what happened with that. I have another video that I talk about that, and this vehicle was found near Chambersburg, Pennsylvania. We know that surveillance footage showed Peter in the store in a convenience store, and he was actually wearing a mask. So that's why I talk about the mask. But he was found in Chambersburg, Pennsylvania, which is where the vehicle was found nearby as well. And then police believed he then got into an Uber from there to Hagerstown, Maryland, where we know that's the last location, and that's where he was ultimately just arrested. So, not very far. It's about 27 minutes from Chambersburg, Pennsylvania, into Maryland. So that got another state involved yet again. We know we already had New Jersey, Pennsylvania, Connecticut. FBI, a lot of agencies involved, and they were able to successfully arrest Peter. Now, that's really the last thing I wanted to talk about. Here's his description in the convenience store. The other update, if there was one that I wanted to mention here, was really it's still evolving. So there's not a whole lot. I think that's the biggest thing is that he was captured without further incident. And I hope you guys found this helpful. This is a short video. I just wanted to get this out quickly. I'll probably do a follow-up once we get even more information so I can dissect that. If you guys are interested, just make sure to subscribe to my channel. I cover other cases as well that are ongoing right now that I post. So I hope you guys found this information helpful, and we'll be back with another episode. This is Dev with Crime Hive. You guys